Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 12th of May. India's COVID-19 deaths cross quarter million as virus ravages countryside. Taliban captures key district near Afghan capital following Eid ceasefire announcement. And Bangladeshis travel home for Eid despite lockdown. And now for all the details. India's total COVID-19 active cases dipped to 3.7 million with a net decline of 11,122 cases in a span of 24 hours on Wednesday. This is the second consecutive day that active cases have dipped. However, coronavirus deaths crossed a quarter million on Wednesday in the deadliest 24 hours since the pandemic began as the disease rampaged through the countryside, overloading a fragile rural healthcare system. India's coronavirus deaths crossed a quarter million on Wednesday in the deadliest 24 hours since the pandemic began as the disease rampaged through the countryside, overloading a fragile rural healthcare system. Deaths swelled by a record 4,205 while infections rose to 348,421 in the 24 hours to Wednesday, carrying the tally past 23 million, Health Ministry data showed. Experts believe the actual numbers could be 5 to 10 times higher. However, boosted by highly infectious variants, the second wave erupted in February to inundate hospitals and medical staff, as well as crematoriums and mortuaries. Funeral pyres have blazed in city parking lots and scores of bodies have washed up on the banks of the holy river Ganges, having been immersed by relatives whose villages were stripped bare of the wood needed for cremations. Many states across India have imposed their own lockdown rules to curb the spread of the coronavirus. Meanwhile, India administered over 175 million COVID-19 vaccine doses, fastest globally. But there is shortage of vaccination across the country. Centre and some state governments are at loggerheads over vaccine supply. Delhi Deputy Chief Minister Manish Sisodia on Wednesday said Covaxin's maker Bharat Biotech has informed the state government that it cannot provide additional Covaxin doses to the national capital. The stock of Covaxin in Delhi has finished and as a result, around 100 vaccination centres set up in 17 schools have been closed, he said.
Covaxin ne kal hame chitthi likhi hai. उन्होंने कहा है कि साफ साफ कह दिया है उन्होंने कि हम वैक्सीन नहीं दे सकते हैं क्योंकि हमारे पास में वैक्सीन उपलब्ध नहीं है उन्होंने अपनी चिट्ठी में लिखा है कि वी आर मेकिंग डिस्पैचेस एज पर द डायरेक्टिव्स ऑफ कंसर्न्ड गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स
ओनली 3 वैक्सीन्स हैव बीन अप्रूव्ड टू बी सोल्ड इन इंडिया कोवैक्सीन कोविशील्ड एंड स्पुटनिक वी Several state governments besides Delhi on Tuesday have decided to issue global tenders for procurement of COVID vaccines as the domestic supply fails to keep up with the rising demand amid the fierce second wave of the pandemic. In news from Pakistan, Pakistan on Wednesday reported less than 3,000 new infections in a single day for the first time since March 16. This comes as the country has intensified its vaccination campaign amid a third wave. Pakistan's planning minister Asad Umar announced on Wednesday that those above 30 years of age will now be able to get themselves registered for the inoculation from May 16.
Pakistan reported 2,869 new infections in a single day on Wednesday, taking the total case load to 867,438 with 19,210 deaths so far. This is the first time in almost 2 months that Pakistan reported less than 3,000 coronavirus cases since March 16. Meanwhile, Pakistan's planning minister Asad Umar informed in a tweet that Pakistanis aged 30 and above will be able to get themselves registered for the coronavirus vaccine from May 16. Walk-in vaccinations for people aged 50 and above are underway in the country since last month. Asad Umar had earlier announced that walk-in vaccination facility for people above 40 years old will be opened from May 12 onwards. The minister had also pointed out the death rate among people under the age of 40 years has risen during the third wave of the coronavirus pandemic in Pakistan. To stem the spread of the virus, the country has been under a complete lockdown for 10 days since 8th of May.
Moving on, journalist and political activists from Gilgit-Baltistan and Pakistan-administered Kashmir have blamed Pakistan for subjugating their voices. During a gathering to discuss freedom of speech, they highlighted deteriorating standards of press in the illegally occupied territories due to government policies.
Journalists and political activists from Gilgit-Baltistan and Pakistan-administered Kashmir have blamed Islamabad for subjugating their voices and harassing them by using draconian anti-terrorism laws. A number of them gathered recently at the Gilgit Press Club to deliberate and discuss the deteriorating standards of press due to government policies and highlighted the government has ensured that the information is denied and their voices are muzzled through intimidation or force.
Right to information, access to information ka jo kanun hai, usko yahan pe ek kirdaar kisam ka jo chief minister tha Sadiqa Mehdisha ne usne yahan pe usko postpone kar diya tha. हमारी कोशिश है कि उसको दोबारा से हम बहाल करवाएं यहाँ पे ताकि है कि हकीकी तौर पे कोई सहाफत हो वरना अगर उस तरह नहीं होगा तो हम किरदार कशी भी करेंगे हम लिखेंगे हमें जो मर्जी आए हम वही करेंगे जो हमारा कोई बिगाड़ सकता है तो बिगाड़ ले कोर्ट जाना है तो पड़े हुए
The journalists highlighted local newspapers are forced to carry news praising the works of the federal or local government else they face censorship. In 2017, Pakistan ordered the shutdown of Mujadala newspaper in Pakistan-administered Kashmir as it carried a survey report that 73% of the people living in the illegally occupied region want independence from Pakistan.
Kashmir ka ye khitta jo hai wo is lihaz se aur khas karke press ke lihaz se bahut zyada subjugated hai aur yahan khabrein jo hai wo logon tak communicate nahi hoti yahi wajah hai ke log ye samajhte hain ke yahan to aisa hi aisa hain aur azad kashmir ke log waqai azad hain jabki dusri jagahon pe log samajhte hain ke unko huquq nahi mil rahe
Over the years a number of journalists have also been charged under schedule 4 of anti terrorism act only those who have fallen in line with the government's versions are safe in the region while others are living constantly under an even expanding shadow of fear.
In news from Afghanistan, the Taliban has captured a key district just outside the Afghan capital Kabul in central Wardak province, forcing government forces to retreat. This comes amid intensifying violence following an announcement by the Islamist group of a three-day ceasefire in Afghanistan for the Muslim religious holiday of Eid starting this week.
The Taliban insurgents captured a key district just outside the Afghan capital Kabul in central Wardak province, forcing government forces to retreat, security officials said on Tuesday. This comes amid intensifying violence following an announcement by the Islamic group of a three-day ceasefire in Afghanistan for the Muslim religious holiday of Eid starting this week. Tariq Aryan, an Interior Ministry spokesperson, said government troops made a tactical retreat from district center, which is a gateway of Kabul, after having firefight with the Taliban. Zabibullah Mujahid, a Taliban spokesman, wrote on Twitter that they had killed and captured some members of the Afghan security forces after seizing the district. He added that they had also seized a large cache of ammunition. The Taliban have dug in the Wardak, which lies less than an hour's drive west of Kabul and in nearby Logar province to the south. Kabul has been on high alert since Washington announced plans last month to pull out all US troops by September 11, with Afghan officials saying the Taliban stepped up attacks across the country following the announcement.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh. Thousands of Bangladeshis walked along highways to reach a ferry terminal near capital Dhaka on Tuesday in a bid to return home for Eid holidays. There has been a ban on land transport amid the nationwide coronavirus lockdown in Bangladesh until May 16.
Thousands of Bangladeshis walked along highways to reach the Mawa ferry terminal 60 km from the country's capital Dhaka on Tuesday in a bid to return home for the Eid al-Fitr holidays following a ban on land transport. The government had suspended all forms of long route transportation such as buses and trains since 3rd of May, although intra-city bus services were permitted to transport passengers. Authorities also allowed only a few selected ferries to cross rivers, in particular those transporting ambulances and trucks carrying essential goods.
আবার মিরপুর থেকে বরিশাল পর্যন্ত করোনার কারণে হয়তো গাড়িগুড়ি সব বন্ধ, তারপর বাপমার সাথে ঈদ কাটাবো এই জন্য গ্রামের উদ্দেশ্যে রওনা দিলাম। এখন পুরো পথে হয়তো অনেক জায়গায় গাড়ি পাইছি, অনেক জায়গায় 1 টাকার ভাড়া 3 টাকা দিয়ে যাইতে হয়েছে, তারপরও অনেক পথ হাঁটতে হয়েছে আমাকে। এখন আমি এই পর্যন্ত
Bangladesh detected its first case of a highly infectious coronavirus variant first identified in India, the country's health directorate said on Saturday. Air travel has been suspended since April 14, when Bangladesh imposed a strict lockdown for a week. Since then, a loose lockdown has been in place until May 16.
In news from Nepal, the suspension on operation of international flights has been extended in Nepal till 31st of May as coronavirus cases continue to rise at an alarming rate. That rate of Nepal has also continued to soar in recent days as hospitals around the Himalayan nation face crunch in supply of medical oxygen. Nepalese authorities have decided to extend ban on international flight till end of May amid surging cases of coronavirus across the Himalayan nation. Issuing a release on Tuesday evening, Aviation Regulatory Authority of Nepal announced extension of flight ban till midnight of 31st May. In notice, Nepal Civil Aviation Authority has directed airlines companies not to open new booking to and from Nepal until further notice. However, medical, chartered and cargo flights will be allowed to fly with permission. Meanwhile, the death rate of Nepal has continued to soar in recent days as hospitals around the nation face crunch in supply of medical oxygen. In the latest, Nepal recorded 225 deaths due to COVID-19, while the new confirmed cases reached 9,317. The COVID-19 pandemic has brought forth many acts of kindness from strangers around the globe who have overcome their own hardships in order to help others. In India's Jammu and Kashmir territory, a houseboat owner who recently recovered from coronavirus has converted his boat into the region's first water ambulance in a bid to help people.
Tariq Ahmed Patlu, a houseboat owner in India's Jammu and Kashmir, has started the unique service of a boat ambulance service to help people, including COVID-19 patients who face difficulties owing to inefficient means of transportation connecting hospitals. Patlu, who lives near the iconic Dal Lake in the summer capital Srinagar, has made all necessary arrangements, including oxygen supply, inside the ambulance to help the patients in the COVID-19 crisis. Locals appreciated Patlu's efforts and said his initiative will help save dozens of lives in the valley.
Bhi jo halaat maine dekhi hai hospital mein kya hai aur logon ke gharon ke andar kitne patients hain, to uski wajah se maine bhi isme thoda aur improvement karne ki socha ki main isko aur bhi develop karun. Iske andar maine stretcher, wheelchair, first aid, oxygen, ye main sab isme rakha hu. Inshallah jaise hi mujhe call aati hai, mujhe calls aate hain roz, jaise hi mujhe call aati hai main jata hu, main unko help kar.
Meanwhile, a government women's college in India's southern Thiruvananthapuram has converted some of its buildings into oxygen ward room and storage center to ensure adequate supply of oxygen to the hospitals amid a raging pandemic. A 20-member team of volunteers is working round the clock to provide oxygen to the hospitals across the country that are in dire need of the life-saving gas to stave COVID-19 deaths. Medical oxygen has become a major concern with hospitals across the country, issuing SOS calls that they were running out of supplies of the life-saving gas because of the crush of patients.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.